Thought I would take a look at a Twitter page of so-called anarchists, because me and Otterface, we have already made fun of Caitlyn Bennett, for instance. We call her the discount Lauren Southern, and she is a lolcow. She really is. Like she says and does the damnedest things, and she's just straight up pathetic. Like she is. She's just a pathetic human being. I also think there's something wrong with her because the way she can just be nasty to people and not feel bad about it, I mean, that's not normal. I don't know what to tell you. I legitimately suspect that she doesn't have a proper conscience. But anyway, yeah, this is the Twitter page of supposed ANCAPs. Okay? So these guys are supposed to be all about, a lack of government and whatever, and just reading through these tweets makes it clear that these people are not anarchists. They're not even libertarians, okay? They are anything but. And I just find it so funny. But anyway, let's read through a couple of these because they are good. The Second Amendment was ratified so the American public can defend themselves against government tyranny. This inherent right means that the public should have access to all the same weapons as the military. Anyone who says differently does not support the Second Amendment. They support tyranny. Okay, stop. Look, I support the Second Amendment. I do. I do. Okay. I don't care if you own an AK or an M16 or just a regular Glock. I don't care. Okay. If you're a responsible gun owner, I don't care. So I'm not one of those people who say, "Oh, we need to ban AR-15s and stuff," because no, that's ridiculous. No, the Second Amendment is pretty clear. People have a right to defend themselves and against the government if it becomes tyrannical. However, one thing that isn't really clear in the Second Amendment is if the heaviest artillery, if that should be allowed to private citizens or just militia. Because being a private citizen is not really the same as being part of a militia. If you're part of a militia, then having anti-aircraft artillery, that makes more sense, I guess, than if you're a single individual. And I'm gonna be honest with you, as much as I support the Second Amendment, and I do, I don't think the average citizen should be able to own a bazooka, let's say, okay? I don't. All right, so here we are responding to a tweet. Also, where is the outrage when Caitlyn threatened to kill a fellow American? You know I carry, right? Tag the police and the FBI department on that video too. Let's get her license revoked. Clearly, she is a threat, irresponsible, and unfit to hold a weapon. Keep the energy up. Okay, to be honest, I don't think she deserves to lose her, fucking ability to carry a gun. Okay, I don't think it's that bad. But let's see what they respond with. She never threatened anyone. A fat SJW who hit her cameraman already approached her aggressively and admit online that night that she intended on assaulting her. She also wished for Caitlyn to be shot and killed. Clearly, leftists like you want her disarmed so someone can kill her. No, that's not true. That's not true. We have the video. The video directly contradicts what you're saying here. Okay? It does. It really does. She told a woman that she doesn't know, she insulted her, said, "Oh, she's gonna try and eat it," referring to the microphone, just because she was fat. And she rightfully got pissed. Okay? So, yeah, if you insult someone for no reason, they're gonna get pissed at you. Then Caitlyn coldly says, "You know I carry, right?" That is a thinly veiled threat. Okay? That is a thinly veiled threat. I don't care what you people say, it is. Normal people don't do that shit, okay? She wanted to intimidate this woman because she rightfully got pissed at her. Okay? So your entire story here is simply not true. You can go fuck yourselves.
She's gonna eat it. You know I carry, right? You know I carry, right? Not to turn it.
Leftists on Twitter are more radicalized than ISIS and worse. It's not even because they have religious convictions. They are so psychotic that their emotions turn them into violent maniacs. Wow. Okay. So, all right, so look, I've already made a video on Antifa. Antifa can go fuck themselves. Antifa are violent and they are thugs and they should be classified as a terrorist organization. I don't care what you people say. I know some people are pissed when I say that, but Fuck you. Fuck Antifa. Okay, they can go fuck themselves. I hate those guys. But they're not on the same level as ISIS. I mean, I sure don't remember seeing any video of Antifa beheading someone. Comparing even Antifa to ISIS is a tad extreme, don't you fucking think? And also, most people on the left are not Antifa. In fact, there is this opinion poll where actually a small minority of people on the left in any way have any kind of sympathy for Antifa. Hehe, Obama takes selfies with wife, so let's forget that he's a war criminal who weaponized the IRS against conservatives and illegally spied on Americans. I love how that's the second thing they mention. It's not like they mention, you know, spying on all Americans first. No, first of all, they mention IRS. What do you mean against conservatives? What? The IRS collects taxes from everyone. It doesn't matter if you're a right winger or a left winger or in the center. Everyone pays taxes. Like, what are you even saying at this point? The fuck is wrong with you? Gay people are not oppressed in this country. They're the oppressors. Okay. Wow. Look, but again, I mean, aren't you supposed to be anarchists? I mean, you guys are not supposed to put your nose in other people's business as long as it doesn't harm anyone. So what I'm wondering is, why are you essentially committing a prostate exam with your nose of every gay person? Leftists are incapable of being reasoned with. Their ideology is wholly irrational and predicated on how they feel and not based on what's moral, just, or logically sound. They are no longer merely debate partners in the marketplace of ideas. They're the enemy of Western civilization. Bravo. Stunning and brave. Stunning and brave. Again, what is it with sicking the FBI on people? Like, what the fuck? You know, I thought we didn't need law enforcement, you know? I thought in your anarchistic society, you would be able to dole out justice yourself with your AK-47, you know? Because, yeah, fuck the state, right? And this one takes the fucking cake. Since LGBTQ gang is trending, shout out to the original LGBTQ gang, Sodom and Gomorrah. I mean, look at this. Look at this. What the fuck, man? What the fuck is wrong with you? It's like, are you saying that it was the right call by God to fucking kill people just because they like to play hide the salami? I mean, come on, really? Get the fuck out of here. Who cares? Who cares? No one is forcing you to fucking have butt sex, so just leave people alone, okay? I mean, fuck, you don't have to like anal to let people engage in anal. I don't see why this is a problem. Just live and let live. Isn't that what anarchists are supposed to be all about? I mean, what the fuck? They call you Nazis while supporting gulags and re-education camps. They call you violent while threatening to burn down cities. This is what we're up against in 2020. Mm-hmm. This is coming from an account where people apparently think that God killing people just because we like to play hide the salami is a perfectly just reaction, okay? I mean, it's like, you can't make this shit up, folks. These are the same people. I'm not kidding. It's like, this is the same account, okay? This is the same account that complains about being called Nazis when they literally seem to be in favor of extermination of people. Like, it's... What? Do you people lack self-awareness? What the fuck? Oh, here we go, here we go. Here comes the juicy parts. The Articles of Confederation were much better than the Constitution. After going to war over taxes, the very first president suppressed a rebellion in order to implement a tax on whiskey. The Constitution created a government larger than the one they rebelled against in 1776. So what I'm wondering is, why do you people want to recreate 1776? Okay, why do I hear this fucking meme from you guys? You know, 1776 will commence again, if apparently it led to a bigger government than was what was before. But I'm not surprised that you guys write this, considering a tweet that I'm going to look at later. The Articles of Confederation were so much better. They were so much better than the Constitution, you know, because making sure that people are not, you know, chained and treated like chattel and forced to work against their will. That's horrible. I mean, state rights, right? You know, states should have the right to enslave people. I mean, come on, it's obvious. You know, state rights, after all. Come on, you know? Who cares about them, Nick? Anyway, moving on. Joseph McCarthy did nothing wrong. Oh my god, this is amazing. Like, here's the thing. If I just came across this account, okay, if I just came across it, and I did not know the history of this account, I would legit think that it was a parody account of ANCAPs. I would, because this is just, wow, okay. Joseph McCarthy did nothing wrong. Yeah, look, he accused people of being communists without any evidence. Aren't you the same people who are against the Me Too movement? And don't get me wrong, rightfully so, because the Me Too movement is cancer. It is. You're against, you know, the witch hunt of Me Too, but apparently just calling people commies without any evidence, that's perfectly fine, I guess. I mean, it kind of shows your true colors, doesn't it? I mean, it was already obvious with the whole Sodom and Gomorrah thing. I just keep coming back to it because it's just so funny. I mean, it's horrible, but it's also funny because it sort of exposes just what horrible fucking people these are. You know, people call us Nazis, and that's mean. Oh, by the way, it was right by God to kill people just because we like anals. Go fuck yourselves. Extra, extra! Hot takes! Get your hot takes, everyone! Come here, get your hot takes! Democracy is not liberty. It is the exact opposite. Democracy is where a mob votes on what liberties to take away from you. Wow, okay. Again, these are people who call themselves anarchists. They are against a system based on maximizing consent. Yes, I know these people don't want to fucking admit it. I know we don't want to fucking admit it, but here's the truth. Democracy is, technically speaking, just a way to maximize as much consent as possible in a society. And that's a good thing. Aren't you people supposed to be all about consent, okay? But I guess you guys would prefer a system where you always had your way, which would technically make you a dictator, which would actually go against anarchy, because then it would be an authoritarian state instead, which doesn't... Yeah. But hey, logic. Who needs logic, right? According to a 2018 study at the Wharton School of UPenn, monarchies are better at protecting property rights and checking abuses of power by elected officials, and they have higher per capita national incomes than democracy. Wow, okay. This is simply not true. No, it's simply not true. Okay? Look, here's the thing. What they don't take into consideration when they study this is that in the nations that have a monarchy and are doing well, the monarchy is pretty much neutered, okay? Or the monarchy just doesn't get involved, okay? They still have a prime minister, and it's the prime minister and his minister's job to actually run the country. The monarchy is just there for some arbitrary reason, because tradition, I guess. When they did this research, they did not take into account the nations where the monarchy actually has power still. And if you look at those nations, what you're going to find is, well, they're doing pretty poorly. In monarchies where the monarch actually rules, it's pretty bad for the most part. You know, people, like, starve and stuff. Because monarchs abuse their power. I mean, who knew? It's not like you can look at, like, European history, like the Middle Ages, where the monarchs held actual power, and it's not like you can see the misery back then at all. Or anything. But yeah, no, I mean, sure, it makes perfect sense that an anarchist is in favor of a monarch. Yeah. There's nothing libertarian slash conservative about using whatever bathroom you want. Gender-neutral bathrooms are the communist idea that there is no such thing as private property, and you can do whatever you please, whatever you want. If you're for that, you're a commie. Yes. Having a bathroom where everyone can go and just do their business and get the fuck out. It's communism. I mean, it makes sense now. I see it, folks. I mean, yeah. And public toilets. I mean, they're super fucking saying communism. Christians should absolutely incorporate their religion into their politics and should absolutely legislate morality. All good laws and basic forms of justice are already based off of Christian values. Property rights, a noble Western value, are a Christian concept. No, it is not. Okay, listen. Listen, bitch. I don't know if you've ever heard of a civilization called Mesopotamia. But it's the earliest civilization that we know of, pretty much. And they actually wrote down their laws on stone tablets. Okay, so this is the earliest instance we know of human beings actually writing down concrete laws, no pun intended, into stone. All right. And one of the laws is, thou shalt not steal. Like you should not steal. And this predates Christianity by thousands and thousands and thousands of years. Are you ready to be fucking burnt to a crisp by the hotness of this take? All right. So let me get this straight. The alphabet people, the alphabet people, think you can call yourself whatever gender you want, but you can't identify yourself as a libertarian. It's almost like words have meanings and you can't just identify as whatever you want. Yes, Liberty Hangout. It's almost like words. Self-awareness, it's a thing. Okay. Oh my God, here we go again. God reading the trending tab on Twitter. Fursuit Friday. If God were female, I get kinky. I am non-binary. Noah, get the boat. It's like, what is it with you people and the glorification of genocide? I just don't get it. I just don't get it. But hey, in any way comparing you guys to the Nazis, I mean, that's clearly a violation, that you definitely have nothing in common with them at all. You both just happen to be, entrepreneurs in the business of genocide, but whatever. Here we go again. Hey Pete, do you have any comment on the airstrike at Sodom and Gomorrah? With you people, I don't get it. Okay. Meanwhile, at the Liberty Hangout headquarters, I don't know if you guys have heard, but man, the gay people, man, they're icky. I know, totally. Like, oh my God, like they're so icky. It's like, ugh. It's like I don't want anyone to shove it up my pooper, so therefore no one else can enjoy it. Yeah. I mean, totally. I mean, that's totally fucking libertarian and shit. Yeah. I mean, totally, right? Oh my God, I'm so glad that you get it. Oh, by the way, did you see that homeless guy outside? Yeah, I felt bad for him, so I gave him some money. Communist! God does not belong to a political party. He also does not approve of putzers.
Like, what is it with you people? I'm serious. I think whoever is in charge of this fucking Twitter account, I mean, they have some kind of fascination with anuses. I don't know what to tell you folks. Like, this is not normal. It's not normal to be this fucking hyper-focused on a piece of anatomy and what people do with it. Like, it's, no. Just get out of the closet, dude. Just get out of the fucking closet. Anyway, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I mean, if you want me to, I guess I can, take a dump on more people on Twitter like this, but, Take care, guys. And yeah, I'm going to try and have that Greta video up as soon as possible. And tomorrow I'm going to upload that video where me and Otterface respond to Sargon. But yeah. Bye.
Oh, sinner, do not stray from the straight and narrow way, for the Lord is surely watching what you do. If you approach the devil's den, turn round, don't enter in, lest the hand of the Almighty fall on you. He'll fuck you up.
He'll fuck you up.
Yes, God will fuck you up. If you dare to disobey his stern command, he'll fuck you up.
He'll fuck you up.
Don't you know he'll fuck you up? So you better do some praying while you